The City of Columbus Division of Police is now accepting applications for their 911 emergency dispatcher position. Today on City Chat. Joining us on set today from Columbus Division of Police, we have Crystal Teamer and Christopher Lyman here to discuss the steps you need to take to apply. Thank you both of you guys for coming on set today. You guys are awesome, and we're really excited to hear about like this new position and how to get started. So let's start off with Christopher. Can you tell us about your position?
My position, I'm the 911 Emergency Communications Specialist. In short, I'm the supervisor of the Communications Bureau of the Division of Police. So I supervise all 911 emergency call takers and dispatchers.
Okay.
And my job is just to make sure everything is staffed appropriately and all things are running smoothly.
That's great.
In the radio room.
And Crystal, what about you?
I am a 911 emergency dispatcher.
Okay.
We do have two different positions. We have call takers and dispatchers. So I do both. I call take and I dispatch to police officers.
Wow, that's awesome. Can you start off by telling us how long is this application period open?
It's open now through February 10th.
February 10th, okay, and it's just open to the public completely. Do we have to do any requirements ahead of time, or can anyone from the public just apply?
Anyone from the public can apply as long as you have the qualifications.
Okay, cool, and we'll dive deeper into that. How can someone who's interested in applying get more information about this job?
So currently we have three upcoming job information sessions that we're gonna be presenting, where applicants or potential applicants can talk with division personnel, employees like ourselves, like myself and Crystal. They can talk with human resources personnel and city civil service personnel on how to figure out the best way to apply. Those sessions are gonna be held at the Chief James G. Jackson Police Training Academy at 1000 North Hague. They'll be held on this Saturday, January 25th at noon. We're gonna also do Tuesday, January 28th at 9 a.m. and Wednesday, January 29th at 5 p.m. Attendance to those sessions is not required, but we highly suggest it. It'll give applicants a chance to kind of see what the job position is all about.
Awesome. Are all the three sessions the same, or are they different sessions?
Correct. The three sessions are all exactly the same. Okay. We just have them at varying times and varying days so that we can hopefully get any schedule accommodated.
So, Crystal, we were talking a little bit about the minimum qualifications earlier. What are those?
Yes, the qualifications will be to have at least completed the 12th grade, have a diploma or a GED, 2 years experience in either a high pace call volume call center or experience answering 911 emergency calls at another smaller center or a large center, performing dispatching duties at another center as well, we would like that experience, or just the clerical and administrative duties in an office environment, but also high pace.
Okay, so all of those qualifications are needed, or just like one of them?
They're needed. Okay. We need you to have some type of experience in a high volume call center or another department, because we're very busy. You have to be able to multitask and keep up with all the work.
Okay, and you know, from a supervisor point of view, for someone who doesn't meet all of these qualifications, how would you suggest, what would you recommend that they do?
So I'd recommend anyone who's still interested apply. Our Civil Service Commission is gonna go through all the applications and determine if your qualifications fit this job.
Okay.
So if you think you may or may not qualify, go ahead and still apply, and then the Civil Service Commission will tell you whether or not you actually do qualify. So for those who are a little bit hesitant, my best piece of advice is just to still apply, and then we can go from there.
Yeah, you know, like I try to imagine, you know, if this was the career I went down, just like how tense, you know, these conversations can be, you know, if someone is calling in, and you know, what kind of like, besides the qualifications, what kind of like temperament you need to have as a person. So this question is for both of you. What kind of skills besides these qualifications should someone possess?
You should definitely be able to handle stress well. You are dealing with people on the worst days of their lives.
Yeah.
So you have to be able to deal with stress and learn how to cope with stress, because it's very important and it's what we deal with every single day.
What about you?
And generally we in our dispatch center, we have a lot of type A personalities, a lot of go-getters, folks who really want to get things accomplished. So that's kind of what we're looking for, those who are willing to go the extra mile, the extra step. But also, like Crystal said, we're looking for folks who have a kind of a calm demeanor, can stay cool under pressure, and perform the job. We're also looking for folks who can multitask, especially as a 911 dispatcher here in the city of Columbus. Our dispatchers deal with about, 30 to 40 units at any one given time, plus the incoming calls for service that the city's dealing with. So they have to juggle all of that at the same time. So we're looking for folks who can kind of multitask, can do multiple things at once, can bounce in and out of tasks and do those types of things. So.
Yeah, props to you guys. That's amazing. I'll go ahead and with this next question for you, Christopher. What are some of the benefits that you can get from being a 911 emergency dispatcher?
So there's, the intangible benefits of actually, like, the days where you get to help people. So those are the kind of the things that you get to take home for the job. But also the city offers a whole bunch of great benefits, great medical, dental, and vision insurance. We believe a great starting pay and great pay. We have a robust vacation and leave time and stuff like that. We also do supplemental insurance, supplemental retirement, and we contribute to state retirement, the Ohio Public Employees Retirement System. So the great wages, great benefits. We're part of a bargaining unit, so that stuff is collectively bargained. So we feel like we're on the forefront of that kind of benefits.
So the city definitely takes care of you guys for sure.
That is one of the perks of the job, is the city benefits. The city does a great job of taking care of us and making sure that we're compensated accordingly.
That's great. Chris was kind of talking about some of the people that you actually get to help. Do you have a specific story that you could share with us where you really felt that you were able to help this person that you were talking to?
I don't really necessarily have one. Because it kind of happens every day. It really does. And sometimes they're sad stories and they don't end the way you want it to, but you still feel happy that you did everything that you could do. And you still feel gratification from helping a child that just found their mom, on the floor not breathing, or, someone trying to help their child that, has gotten into drugs. And it's, you try to help everybody you can, and some people just don't know what to do.
So this job sounds like it's like never really boring.
No, it's different every day. Yes.
Yeah, that's the great part about the job. It literally is every day is something different. You can come into work and have no expectations, not have anything that, and you don't know what you're going to get. And that's the great part about it. Also, at the end of the day, unlike some jobs, you can kind of leave work at work. Once you're done, you're done. You don't have any projects looming. You don't have anything, any deadlines looming. You just take care of what's presented to you that day.
Wow, that's really cool. This question is for the both of you. What for you personally, what's the best part about being a 911 emergency dispatcher?
I think there are a lot of good things. I do like feeling like you help someone, and not just the people that call, it's the officers as well when you're dispatching them and getting them help. So you always feel like you're helping someone and you feel accomplished. And I mean, it's good to feel that way.
Definitely. And as a supervisor, what's the best part about
the job? So I used to be a dispatcher, so I used to feel all those things. Now for me, my role has changed a little bit, but what I like most now as a supervisor is seeing what I like to say, like the wheels align, the cogs align, where when I see everyone in our bureau, in our room, just kind of working together to solve the problem, whether that is to find a lost child, whether that is to get officers help, whatever the situation that is thrown at us, us all working together is one of the kind of the best senses of accomplishment that I can get. And to know that, we're doing everything we can to help, the citizens of Columbus. So.
To learn more about the steps you need to take to become a 911 emergency dispatcher, you can attend one of the informational sessions coming up or visit columbus.gov/911. Thanks for watching City Chat on CTV.